So, first of all, let's take a look at what we are going to deal with. This is the condition of the dining area come play area that is of my house. I call it dining area because Vivan eats in this area. We don't have a dining table over here, and it's a play area as well. And I am going to organize this area, clean this area deeply today. So let's simply start, shall we? First things first, as I have always mentioned, that when you want to clean a space, you should simply start subdividing things, like removing things that don't belong to that particular area, continuously discarding things that do not need to be stored in that area, and the things that are supposed to be organized. Now, this chest of drawer has three different drawers in it and two cabinets in it. So the drawers are used as multiple different organizers. The top drawer has miscellaneous items in it. It has medication, it has tools and whatnot. Like literally, you people have seen that the condition of this drawer is extremely very, very horrible. Anything, like finding anything in this drawer, was completely impossible. So let's start organizing it. What I am doing, I am simply following the steps that I have mentioned earlier, that the things I need or the things I have to use, I'm keeping them on top, and the things I need to discard are going in the bottom. Now, I have wiped the first cabinet completely from inside, and now I am going to go ahead and organize everything box by box. This box has been created as a toolkit. In the corner, I am organizing Vivan's nipples. Everything that is additional is going in that box with lid. That is a cup box that I use for storage. Then there is a basket which has all of mine and my husband's medicines. Now call me crazy, but I have this nagging fear of these COVID medications, so I'm just getting rid of those medications that were bought during COVID, discarding the additional batteries, arranging the needles and threads of mine over here. And I'm going to add up an additional basket over here in which I'll organize all of my cables, my earphones, my chargers, like phone charger, laptop charger, and one another charger, and the watches as well. And I'm going to discard anything that is additional. This is a prescription which I'm going to store, and the poly bag is going to be discarded. The first drawer is complete. Now I'm going to switch over to the third drawer. Second drawer is a later thing, but first let's go towards the third drawer. The third drawer was a miscellaneous drawer. Now it is like it has I don't know how many toys in it stuffed. Like I continuously keep on pulling it out and just storing, stacking everything that I can inside. And multiple toys are like useless for Vivan at the moment because like they've gone stale, because adding up batteries even are incapable of making them work. So I'm gonna get rid of those toys. Just don't hang on to them, because your kid will never prefer something that he has already used in a good condition. If you have let them use things in good conditions, they won't probably adjust with things that are not in that similar condition. So just get rid of those, give them to someone who can actually enjoy them, like the ones that I have stored in that poly bag. Those are gonna go in the donation pile or discard pile. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and wipe clean the interior part of the second one as well, and then I am going to store everything in an organized manner. For that, like puzzles like these can be used, can be organized in packets they have arrived in, like this Hindi puzzle, it arrived in this package. Or you can use Ziploc pouches like these, like this number puzzle I am arranging in this Ziploc pouch. I am arranging the alphabets puzzle over here as well. This is like an easier trick of organizing your puzzles, because it won't take a lot of space, and if you will try to store them in boxes, they will take a lot of space. Now I've got a space for a box over here, so I am storing the train set of my son in this box. This is a magnetic train set that I bought for him to introduce the idea of magnets, and then another train that he has, I am storing it in this as well. It's just easier for me to stack everything and over here and grab whatever I want and just give it to him for playing. Now here you can see the discard pile is like ranging upwards. I have stored some newspapers in the last like bottom drawer, and a couple of toys over there as well. Now I am switching towards the cabinets. The cabinets are transparent. I haven't decided what I'm going to place in these cabinets for now, but still, cleaning them was an important step, so that's what I am doing at the moment. For cleaning any wood material, it is better to go ahead with water, and if you want to clean it on a deeper basis, you can add some oil to the water as well if you want to, but just go ahead and clean everything. Wood has absorption capacity, so you need to make sure that whatever you are using for cleaning your wooden material shouldn't be damaging, like the nature shouldn't be damaging. Now over here you can see my drawers are completely organized. Now I'm taking care of the top section. I went ahead and wiped all the photo frames. They are disbalanced a little bit. I was quite in a rush, so I didn't arrange them well, I guess. Now I am going to switch towards this bookshelf, as you people can see me doing right over here. And this bookshelf, like I have told you earlier, this has a tendency of, you know, accumulating clutter, so I am just trying to sort it out at the moment. And I'm really proud that while I am doing this voiceover, a week later recording this video, the bookshelf is in similar condition. So like organizing this one turned out really good. Now I am switching completely towards this bookshelf and making sure all the additional books that that are supposed to be discarded are being kept in a separate pile, and then the books that needs to go inside are kept in a separate pile as well. I am completely making sure that I am wiping and cleaning everything, every section while I'm cleaning them. I just make sure that shelves that have sections like these, I start from top and keep on organizing and cleaning and placing stuff wherever I want to. So over here you can see me doing exactly the same. Now things that belong to my husband's office are going to shift towards my husband's office. My husband is a CA and he works from home sometimes. He has clients that come at our home as well, so he has a separate room as his office, and it's something that I keep my eyes on, but I can't ask him to drop it or give it to me. But it's okay, it's perfectly fine giving him that perfect small little room to entertain his guests. But right now I am just trying to make sure that his bookshelf is only his bookshelf and nothing else. So that's what I am doing, and this is a habit that I did wanted to share with you people. I have, and that is, I always have a register somewhere around me while I'm working, because I get, I get amazing ideas while I'm working. So I have this habit of continuously writing down the ideas, because it's just really very easy to, you know, write them down while you are thinking about them. Otherwise they are just going to vanish from the brain somewhere. I guess brain has like multiple different windows open all the time, and we keep on thinking multiple things. So the ideas, if you are getting any, then you are supposed to write them down. Otherwise you're going to completely forget them. So this is an amazing habit you can opt for. Now I have removed books. The bottom drawer was extremely dirty, and the books in the bottom drawer were extremely dirty. So here I am removing the books and cleaning up the bottom drawer as well to make sure that it is looking really very clean as I wanted it to be. Now this is my son's table and chair. He uses it for dinner and he uses it for writing as well, so I am cleaning that. Now this is the first time in the history of my channel that I am showing you cleaning this keychain holder, and this is just one of the most amazing things that I did invested in. It stocks not only keychains, but it also stocks our masks and caps as well, cap of Vivan. And this is like a thing that I regret having in the dining area because it's just useless for us. But it is like made up of glass and it adds to the beauty somehow, as the owner of our house thinks. So I just try to keep it clean as much as possible. So I am just wiping it out with the help of my glass cleaner. It is a DIY glass cleaner, and I am cleaning the steel area and the glass area with the help of my cleaner to give it a good wipe, to make sure that it is shining sparkly. And post I will complete cleaning this thing, my entire like play area is clean, dining and play area is clean. Like my little helper is also helping me out at the moment. So hopefully you people might have enjoyed this video and found it motivating. If you did, don't forget to give this video a big fat thumbs up. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you people haven't already. I'm seriously enjoying a lot creating these videos for you people. Hopefully, you people are enjoying watching them as well. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Till then, just stay blessed and take very good care of yourself. Bye-bye.